So in today's webinar, we're gonna teach you regarding the introduction of the field, the current market trends, state of art in this field, leading softwares which you can utilize for this automotive industry. Mainly we gonna focus about the leading software because this is the key point while you are planning to be into this domain. The technical content and the typical job and the opportunities are endless. This also I'm going to brief you during this presentation, how you can get into this domain and what are the opportunities you can get. The typical job roles in the senior levels, if you are already being into this automotive field or any other field at the current position like executive or senior executive, how you can be a senior level position into this automotive lighting field. One case study I will show you, and how you can get into this domain. And end of the session, we're gonna be a question and answer round. So all right guys, let's begin with the introduction of this field. So guys, automotive lighting field is basically a safety purpose which we have invented. While you are seeing any car, any big vehicle, you notice that always there will be a front light and the tail light. The purpose of the headlight is to see, because this headlights and the headlamp is the eye of the vehicle. So while driving, you have to see the road. To see the road, we use the headlight. While the taillight function or the tail lamp function is to be seen, you have to notify the back user that the position of your car on the vehicle is at this position. So this taillight denotes you are to be seen. Also, there is an indicator you always there into your vehicle. Why? Because you have to indicate the back user that you are going into this particular direction. So these are the main features, and this is the safety purpose features which has to use into the automotive lighting field. So basically the introduction of this field, you can say, is automotive lighting technology plays a very important role into the motor vehicles with the regards of the safety of vehicle equipment and that other road users. So this is the safety for you as well as the other users of the road. So in the during this presentation, I will also explain what are the other function and how nowadays a trend this automotive lighting changed into the safety as well as the styling also. So let me give you a current trend. In this, you can see the Mercedes used to be like this glass headlamps previously, but now it has been changed from the glass to the plastic. So major this industry now working on the plastics only. Why? Because the plastic is very cheap rather than the glass, and as well as there are many other factors which impact on the lamp. If you use the glass, heat will be more, and the other factors which impact on the headlight. So now they have changed the trend to the plastic. As well as you can see, previously only the function of this lamp was only headlamp, tail lamp, but now you can see there are this, let me show you this DRL. This is the, this always be there in nowadays in every vehicle. This is the daytime running lamp. So this all things is has been changed from this to this 1950 to, you can see, 2015. A drastic change has been done into the automotive lighting field. So some other trends you can you should know about is the laser headlamps and the adaptive lights also, can you can say. In the adaptive lights, what happen is when you see a lamp or when you see the headlamps, the focus always be into your eyes. You might be, if you are a driver, if you have run any vehicle, you might be seeing then the front passenger, if you come crossing to you, you can see the focus into your eyes. So nowadays trend is changing. The focus has not be directly be on the user. I mean, not be in the opposite side driver. When you see the lamp, it will not focus onto your eyes. It will be changed. So this is called as an adaptive light. Next is projector headlamps and projector tail lights also be there. So projector headlamp basically bifunctional headlamps where you can use the same bulb But at the focus side, you can see a focus side. In the current market scenario, if you go with the Maruti small vehicles like Alto and the K10 and the other Wagoner, they are not using projector lamp. Projector lamp is a costly product. So they are not using into this lower class vehicle. But as far as this higher segment is concerned and now trend is concerned, the projector headlamp has been used. The DRL. DRL is everywhere nowadays. It's a huge trend changer, into this market. So DRL, it denotes is daytime running lamp. What it means is during the daytime, if you the fog is there, if any nowadays in you can see the Delhi is having a huge pollution, so visibility is very low. So to focus on the light and to see, the DRL has been introduced previously as a safety feature, but now it is being as a styling feature also. The sequential blinker it means is the indicator. So in regular basis, you might have seen the indicator is blinking one by one, but in the sequential blinker, Audi A4 is the example. You can search after this webinar onto the YouTube and the Google also. The LED, the sequence of LED, like if there are 10 LEDs, one by one they are litting, one by one they are on and getting off. So this is called as a sequential blinker. So major change has been implemented into the lighting feature based on the demand and the safety purpose also. Let me go to the next, the state of art in this field. What does it mean is the changeover. What is the future of this in this industry? What is the key that the change which has been introducing or which has been happening into this lighting field? So you can check out this YouTube link also. The link will be shared by the Ashok later on. So the basic, as this you can see by this image, you might have noticed while the cornering, the focus always be straight because you can't turn the headlamp into the angle. So this change happening in the current market with the AFS and the without AFS is means adaptive front lighting. As I told you earlier, this is the major change into this current market. So see here, the pedestrian is there, but you can't see while the corner you are making a turn. You cannot able to see the pedestrian, but by this AFS system you will be able to see the pedestrian, and at the same time pedestrian also able to see your vehicle because the focus will not be on his eyes. So this is the cutting edge technology we are introducing into this market, and the opportunity are endless. You can think anything you can regarding to the safety of a pedestrian, regarding to safety of a opposite driver, whatever imagination you are having, whatever ideas you are having, those are being implemented into this lighting field. So the opportunities are endless. And another thing, because these are the key factors of any vehicle. If you are seeing a vehicle, you definitely notice the headlights and the tail lights. So whenever the new launch is happening, suppose a facelift is going to happen of any vehicle, existing vehicle, the Quid example you can take. Quid is a successful model nowadays running into the market, and they have launched a facelift version of Quid. In the facelift version, they have not changed a major exterior, but they have changed the lighting because lighting is the key element of the styling also. So they have changed the lighting, headlights, tail light. They have introduced the DRL into this and facelift. So whenever the change or new model has been introduced into the market, the headlights and tail lights always has to be changed. So why I'm telling this to you, because the opportunities, because if the part has been carryovered, they are a question mark on your job also, because if the part has been made and that part is going to utilize for the multiple vehicle, then what is your job? What you will do in the next time? But in the headlight and the tail light or the lighting industry, always change is happening. So the opportunities and the this your position security always be there, because whenever the change is happening, your requirement will be there. Let me moving to the leading software. This is the major key point, guys. The leading software in this industry nowadays is CATIA. The software modeling will be done, the 3D modeling will be done on this CATIA only. There are other software also. Let me give a small introduction of those software, because in the lighting division, there are many factors which we have to consider. So CAE, the analysis software, is major software I'm talking about. There are other software also similar to this software, but the major industries like Minda, Lomax, and other industries, what they are using is ANSYS, the CATIA, ANSYS, and the lighting simulation software. Lighting simulation software is used for to simulate the light. As of now, the unit of the light is candela. So I'll tell you one example. In the headlight, the 20,000 candela is required to see the road. So if the 20,000 candela, while designing, we have to simulate whether this optical reflector is giving that output or not. If it is not giving, there is no use of that reflector. So we have to simulate that how much light we are getting from that reflector and from that design which we have made. So this lighting simulation software will give you an approximate idea that by using this design, you will get a 21,000 candela. So this is a 10%, 20% margin we will take care. So lucid shape is the name of that software which we use for this lighting simulation. The electronics component. Nowadays, previously we used to have the bulb, which PY21, P21, this is the pin type bulb, which used into this lighting. Nowadays, a major change happened and the LED has been introduced during this designing. So if the LED is there, the electronics part will be there. If the electronics part will be there, the circuit design will be there. If the circuit design is there, we have to simulate our circuit that the series and the parallelity has been working or not as per the our idea generation. So we have to simulate, and there is always a major role of the space constraint. So during the space constraint, we design, then we give to the electronic guy and they will tell this is possible or not. So how they will tell? They will tell by using this electronic circuit design. So Eagle is the software, it's the Autodesk. So you can use this Eagle software to simulate the electronic circuit. If LED is not there, wiring harness will be there. If LED is there, wiring harness will also be there. So to simulate the wiring harness means wire which connect to the female connector to the male connector. Through the wire only the electronics will be passed. So the electricity will be passed. So that wiring harness design has to be very simple and very has to be cost impactive. It should not be great more, and it should be not less also. So to simulate the exact amount, how much wire you required for that particular design, the rapid harness is the software which you can use to simulate how much length is required for a particular design. Now coming to the next, you can say the marketing thing, because rendering and the sketching. So once any idea coming to your mind regarding this can be a possible design for my headlamp, and suppose you have assigned one project of the tail lamp, so you might be thinking that how I can design a unique lamp. So you can use the sketching software, you can use the rendering software to show the virtual imagination of your idea to the customer or to the end user. So major software which has been used for this is KeyShot and the Photoshop. If you know this software, then you can use you can go with the rendering and the sketching also. If not, it is okay. Now let's focus on the CATIA. So CATIA, basic CATIA, if you are aware, then it is okay in this industry, because in the lighting field, the surfacing is the key point. So if you know the surfacing and the assembly, that is okay. So I'll give you one simple introduction of CATIA, how many workbench are there for this lighting division only. There are 75 workbench which has been used for the CATIA, but in the lighting industry, 4 workbench has been used for this. One is part design, Second, GSD, that is the generating shape design module. Third is assembly, and fourth is drafting. So KTI is more strong to the drafting. So design, drawing, whatever 3D you are making, the 2D has to be made into the KTI only, because the power of 2D drawing in the KTI is endless. Every industry nowadays moving to the KTI because of its drawing power as well as the GSD power. GSD is the, is a key point to be into this lighting field. If you are the master of GSD, you can have a good opportunity. You can be a good, you can earn a good package also. You can earn good money also in the automotive industry, because GSD is a basic need into the lighting. Why, I will tell you later on. So for the installation is KTI, the basic requirement is minimum 8 GB RAM you should have. The graphic card should be more GB or more, 4 GB or more. The NVIDIA graphic card is recommended. The hard disk should be 500 GB, and the processor is i3 plus. I mean, i3 is the basic, then you can go for the i7 also. Now, technical content. What are the key features and what are the technical content into the automotive lighting field? So basic thing, basic is plastic. You should be knowing about the plastic basic. What is the base thickness you should maintain? What are the deformation happening into the plastic? What are the rejection of these plastics and how this plastic industries work? Basically, this basic requirement will be there always. Second, regulation, because as I told you earlier, it's a safety feature. Later on, it becomes the styling feature also, but initially it was introduced for the passenger safety as well as the pedestrian safety. So regulation is there. The automotive standards are there, which can be in the terms of ECE and AIS. The regulation part is very huge, very huge. But the basic requirement of any lamp, if you are designing a head lamp or if you are designing a tail lamp, the basic regulation know-how should be required for you. Because by designing, if you are not considered those parameters, the output will be not as per the demand. Next, the CAE softwares. If you know this, then it's good for you. It's a plus advantage always. But if you don't know this software, that is okay, because every company into this lighting field is having another set divisions for the age category in the CAE. If I talk about the photometry, they are photometry guys who do only photometry. They don't touch anything else. The thermal guys who only do the thermal simulations, they don't do anything else. The electronics guy as well as the rendering guys, they have each and particular department. So they don't touch the 3D, they don't touch the 2D, and they are having a different this domain. And whatever, suppose you are having a tail lamp and your partner is having head lamp, so the task of these guys are to simulate those head lamp, tail lamp by their end. You don't have to worry about how the photometry will be meet or not. This is their understanding how they will develop us optics based on your input. I mean, whatever design you have made, if you give this design to the CAE guy or the photometry guy, they will tell you, if you modify like this, then we will meet the photometry requirement. So this is how it works. Now the major part here is 3D design. This is the key element of this industry. I will tell you one case study also, by that you can understand how the 3D design is a major role in this industry. For the 3D design, definitely you have to focus on the KTI. If you are the pro in the KTI, then you don't be have to worry about anything. If you know the plastics basic only, if you know the regulation basics only, if you don't know about the CAE, that is okay. And if you don't know about the testing also, that is also okay. But 3D and 2D is must. And this industry, automotive industry, works only on KTI for this 3D and the 2D. So KTI is their power. So next is 2D. 2D is also be done into this KTI. So you have to be aware about the 2D element also into the KTI. Now last is testing and validation. Once the design is ready, 3D is ready, 2D is ready, all things are ready, the lab testing will be done on the product, actual plastic part, which will be into your hand. So those testing has to be done on the part. If that test has been passed, then your lamp will be fitted on the vehicle. So this is how it works. Now, typical job and the opportunity. The opportunities, as I said, is very huge, very endless, because I told you the reason also. Every vehicle, every facelift vehicle, or whatever things is going to be into this market, it's not about the four-wheeler, it's about the two-wheeler also, because two-wheeler is also having the headlights and the tail lights. Four-wheeler also, a commercial also, passenger also, commercial. In the commercial also, the head and tail lamp being used, because every big vehicle, if you are seeing 16-wheel trucks, 18-wheel trucks, whatever is there, the regulation parts should be there. The regulatory parts means the indicator, the tail lamp, the head lamp should be there. So the opportunities into these fields are endless.